Hi, I'm Beth, and this is Steph from Vaddio, and today we are going to be talking about the RoboSHOT 30E NDI camera. Mm-hmm. Ooh, brand new
now camera.
Now available. Exciting. So this presentation is going to be short. We're going to talk about kind of NDI from NewTek, NewTek's NDI in general, mm-hmm. and then also what is special about our RoboSHOT 30E NDI camera. Mm-hmm. We'll go over some tech specs of the Elite series and the NDI camera, as well as some application diagrams, mm-hmm. and then what you can expect when you order your RoboSHOT 30E NDI. What's going to come in the box.
Yeah,
that'll wrap us up.
Yeah, I think that about covers it.
Okay. Right,
let's get into it. Okay, so what is NDI? What are those three letters at the end of our new camera's name? If you're not familiar with transport, it basically video over a network, video, audio, and control over a network, and AV over IP standard, basically. Okay. And so this standard has the ability to transport really beautiful video, high definition at a really low latency. And then the kind of extra cool thing is that it's also doing control over that exact same kind of connection.
Okay. I do like to insert that Legrand is our parent company. Mm-hmm. So Vaddio is a brand of Legrand, as well as Luxel is a brand of Legrand. And some people say, is NewTek a brand of Legrand? And that's not true. NewTek is just a great partner that we have. So they are not affiliated with Legrand right now.
No, we've just been working very well with them.
Yes. So I just want to make that clarification real quick. So mm-hmm. you can keep going.
Yeah. Okay. So why are we transporting video over a network? You know, basically, previously, any other kind of connection, we've got a source, whether that's a camera source or a switcher or something, needs to get to some destination. So we might run some AV cabling of some kind. And if our source doesn't have multiple outputs to go to multiple destinations, we might bring that to a DA or distribution amplifier to get it out to those multiple destinations. And then, you know, hopefully, you know, that DA can handle more as you need to distribute to more locations. So with this, you need to run dedicated coax for SDI, mm-hmm. HDMI cabling, or active HDMI bail-in or extender pairs, things like that. Basically, dedicated AV cabling in order to get your sources to your destinations. Mm-hmm. And the cool thing about AV over IP, where you know a lot of stuff is heading, is that instead you just replace that distribution amplifier with a network switch, and now any source can go to kind of any destination within that ecosystem on that network switch. Now, this diagram doesn't look very different than what I just showed you. I just changed out a DA for a network switch, however. Yeah. Now you can do a whole bunch of stuff like jumping between different network switch points in order to get to, you know, a longer destination without kind of adding a whole bunch of extra AV equipment between point to point.
This diagram could get real crazy.
It really could. Like, I'm trying to make it nice and simple for you, but I mean, any source somewhere can go to any destination somewhere. Any of these sources here can go to any of these destinations. Mm-hmm. Super easy peasy. Your topology can start to look kind of crazy, and you don't have to run dedicated AV wiring anymore. You just need to make sure that you have a nice network to get you wherever you need to go. So NDI is designed to go over most existing networks. They do require gigabit Ethernet over all the network ports between point to point. So you don't want, you know, one little switch somewhere that doesn't have the right specs bottlenecking everything.
Okay.
But, you know, so those are basically the requirements to send the high quality NDI video. They do recommend greater than gigabit network, just so you don't have to, you know, have things to handle other traffic possibly while you're trying to transport your video. You know, they do have a really nice white paper where they talk about all sorts of recommendations and things, firewall settings, cabling recommendations. And since it's their standard, we definitely recommend that, you know, you take a look at their recommendations. It's super easy to find. I think I just looked up NDI networking requirements, mm-hmm. and it was easily the first result. So
most folks know that Luxel mm-hmm. is a partner brand of ours, and so definitely the Luxel AMS series and XMS series have been tested. We've done all that research for mm-hmm. you, and they are, you know, a recommended solution for that NDI ecosystem. Mm-hmm. So no worry about that if you order one of those. I think we're going to show up on the screen the AMS 1208P, which is doing 8 ports of PoE plus and then a 12-port switch total. Mm-hmm. So that's a popular one.
Yes, and in fact, anybody who saw us at Infocom show this camera off for the first time, it was running on this exact model of switch.
It might be my favorite. I'm not going to hide it. Yeah. So
So the question becomes, now that we're talking about sending video over a network, how is this different than other IP streaming that you might be familiar with? So what makes NDI different from H.264? So it's similar. They are sending audio and sometimes, video and sometimes audio over a network. The H.264 is usually an AV source. NDI is specifically sending control protocols as well. And the way that the data arrives is just a little bit different.
Okay.
So it's gonna look a little bit different. They have the ability to have a little bit less latency, and I find it's a lot smoother.
Mm-hmm.
So NDI as a protocol is easier to run over a network and have that like live high def video go point to point.
Okay.
The main ideal is if you've invested in an NDI ecosystem as your AV over IP solution, we have a great camera.
Fantastic
that you can get
camera.
To put into that ecosystem.
Mm-hmm. The professional grade PTZ camera, yeah.
Yeah, and in fact, it is the first camera that you can buy that is doing NDI natively, which we'll get into in a second here.
Yeah.
So when we're talking about NDI, we kind of have to differentiate between a couple of things that NDI can do.
Yeah.
So per talking about that H.264 video earlier, NDIHX is a kind of NDI, where they're basically converting an H.264 IP stream and putting it in an NDI wrapper to get you into that NDI ecospace. Now, that can happen a couple different ways. NewTek has a free software that they have, I think Connect Pro, where you can take an H.264 stream, say from a Vaddio product that does H.264, mm-hmm. and it will convert it to that NDIHX to get you into an NDI ecosystem. So your video runs over your network to the computer that then converts it and then sends it elsewhere.
Yeah, so the NDIHX is like it's high efficiency, it's low bandwidth solution.
Mm-hmm.
It's really, there's a lot of NDIHX solutions out there.
Yes, and in fact, some of them are not doing it in this two-piece solution like I'm talking about. Some of them are actually doing NDIHX internally in the device.
Mm-hmm.
So one part of the chipset on the board will generate an H.264 IP stream,
mm-hmm.
And then another part of it will then convert it to that NDIHX.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a conversion happening internally before it gets out the back ports of the product.
Yeah.
So there's a little bit of difference between that and NDI that is generated natively. It's not doing the work to go through that conversion.
Mm-hmm.
So it is lower latency, smoother video as a result of not doing the conversion.
Yeah, so as of this recording, Vaddio is the only camera on the market right now that is available that's doing that kind of native NDI.
Mm-hmm.
Signal coming out. It's not doing that conversion.
Right. We're not generating it and then converting it before it hits out right. the backport. We are doing native NDI.
Yeah.
We're generating it natively within the camera.
So if you were to compare the two images, they're both fantastic solutions.
Mm-hmm.
NDI in general is a great protocol to follow.
Mm-hmm.
But the RoboSHOT 30E NDI camera does have lower latency and it is an amazing image quality.
Yep.
So
what product are we offering? We're offering the 30E NDI. So the E stands for Elite.
Mm-hmm.
It is based off of our new RoboSHOT Elite camera architecture. We just premiered the Elites a little bit ago.
Yep.
So if you're familiar with them, it's got similar features, which we'll go over in a second here. But yeah, Elite camera. The outputs on it, we are going to have simultaneous NDI streaming, and then you get a courtesy HDMI output to do whatever you want with.
So I get a lot of questions, you know, so I have an Elite camera, can I just add NDI to it? And that answer is you can't at this moment. This is a unique part number. It is the RoboSHOT 30E NDI camera. It's not something that you can add to an existing SDI camera.
Right, it's
or
not
an
a conversion.
HDMI or USB,
mm-hmm.
Which you can do with other NewTek products, which is, that NDIHX.
Mm-hmm.
But to get the full NDI camera that this is offering, it is a unique part number.
Mm-hmm. And then the other thing that people ask is, do I need something else? Do I need to get something other than this camera? And really, you just kind of need to make sure that your network is, meets all the specs that they're looking for, and then you might want to download some of the free NewTek software that they have for, processing the video to the many different locations that it can go. They have a suite of tools available on their website for free.
Yep.
So let's talk about the physical stats of the camera. I'm such a nerd. I'm calling them stats like we're playing Dungeons and Dragons. Okay. So it is a 30 times zoom. Mm-hmm. Like our other elites with the 30 times, it is a 20 times optical. Mm-hmm. And then the rest of the 30 gets you there with IntelliZoom. And we're going to go over what IntelliZoom technology is if you're not familiar yet. It is a 1080p 60 maximum resolution camera. It's got a beautiful XMORR CMOS sensor, which we are filming on right now. So this is super smooth.
We look good.
This is what the camera can look like. This is a practical demonstration of the RoboSHOT Elite 30s.
Okay.
The horizontal field of view, when you're zoomed all the way out, the wide angle that you can get, we have a 70.2, and again, that is from left to right. So if you're doing like a comparison, it's not a diagonal measurement. This is, you know, a usable, hey, how much of the room can we capture? 70.2.
Compare apples to apples. Sometimes people throw in a diagonal and that'll throw
like a TV. Then it has the beautiful smooth electrostatic motors for the smooth camera movement, tri-synchronous presets, custom home, you know, all the really cool RoboSHOT movement features. The camera is PoE plus powered, which means that on a single cable to its port, you know, you can get up to 100 meters extension to the switch that you're running it to get it to the network. Which ships with a power injector that you can do that, or else, obviously, if you get a switch that provides PoE plus, like that AMS 1208, then, you know, it can be provided power from the switch. There is something that is really cool in a lot of our RoboSHOT Elite cameras that is something we've added recently, so you might not even know about this.
Hot off the press.
Yes. So we have a, you can set the rotary on the back of the camera to be your camera's output resolution, and we have a position zero now, where you can change that resolution in the camera's web interface.
Yeah.
So if you have it up in the ceiling and you want to change resolution on the fly, you don't have to get up there and move that. You can just get into the web interface and pick a different resolution.
Very easy.
Easy peasy. Obviously, what I'm talking about, it still has the Vaddio web interface that you can control the camera from. You know, not dedicated to any browsers, just be somewhere on the network as the camera, open up a web browser of your choice, type in the IP address and go to town. The NDI and the HDMI outputs are indeed simultaneous.
Yes.
So it's not an either or, you get both.
Yep.
Just as a note, because we're doing NDI streaming and, you know, we're giving you the full, you know, native bandwidth there, this camera does not do the RTSP or the RTMP streaming because we're using all that bandwidth for the NDI output.
Yeah, and so we're thinking that if you are, you know, selecting the RoboSHOT 30E NDI camera, you are using it in an NDI ecosystem.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then obviously, there's a couple different kinds of control. You're probably using NDI if you're in an NDI. But what also works, the web interface, Telnet control to the camera, and serial, they all still work. So just because you have NDI control doesn't mean you lose those control options as well. So talking about IntelliZoom.
My favorite part.
Yeah. So IntelliZoom is a really cool thing to do with the optics of the camera and the way that it zooms in. So it has a 20 times optical zoom to get you to that first part there. And then what we're doing after that is we are able to generate pixels. When like a digital zoom zooms in, they're kind of stretching a picture and you're not getting the full true like 1080p image all the way through. You're losing, you know, pixels and clarity. And what this is doing is it's a really cool algorithm that's running, and it's very pretty. We have a lot of sample videos somewhere. Take a look so you can see this in action. But it's taking a pixel, say like a yellow pixel, and it's looking at everything around it so that if, say, there's a red pixel right here, instead of, you know, generating more yellow and red pixels and just making the image kind of more muddy and indistinct, it's generating an orange pixel between them. And so you get a really beautiful, clear image. And the reason why you kind of want to do this is because on one of the, you know, unfortunate things about optical zoom at the end of its zoom is that, say, you're zoomed in on a piece that's, you know, physically, we're looking at this here.
Okay.
only this amount of physical light is going back to that camera lens. So if you're in kind of a low light situation, when you're zoomed all the way in, it can be kind of difficult to kind of account for how much less light you're even getting at that zoom. So we're still collecting all the light at that 20 times optical zoom, but you're still able to get a tight shot here with the light collected here. Yeah.
So think of your live events, auditoriums, theaters, you know, especially when you are going to be using that NDI ecosystem, which we see a lot of growth in the light broadcast and houses of worship, where you are maybe in some really interesting lighting conditions. This is an excellent camera to have in your arsenal.
Yes. So we're going to do, again, so some design and application, and quick, because this is very easy to install places. So basically, you set your camera up, you point it at whatever you want to film, your area of interest.
Like a kiwi.
Like a kiwi, like a hedgehog, like a Frankenstein.
Yes.
It's a monster.
Yes.
And you connect it to your network. We have a 1208 here, because it's Beth's favorite.
The AMS 1208P, yes.
And then you basically, you know, send your NDI stream off to wherever it needs to go, you know, whatever is collecting that on the other side. So the other part of your network, another network switch, just kind of wherever it's going. There are a lot of programs, again, the NewTek tools available, so you can ingest that on a computer. There are programs so that you can ingest the video over the network and use it for things like Zoom or recording or capture on your laptop, just as long as you're somewhere in the same building as the camera. On the network.
Yeah.
Or you could run it to like a piece of NewTek's hardware, like
the TriCaster
Mini. And then again, your networking connection is kind of your own deal, just as long as you're anywhere on the network.
It's pretty easy.
Yeah.
Pretty easy. Okay.
So what comes in the box? A camera, obviously. It also comes with a matching wall mount and some mounting hardware. The camera comes in solid black or solid white, and the mount comes in a matching paint. And then you also get a PoE Plus power injector, which you can use if you don't have a switch that provides it. And then an IR remote.
Yeah, that's all you need to get going.
It's very easy to get this and just pop it down and get it working in your NDI ecosystem. And then obviously that's not a tangible thing that you can lift out of the box, but you do obviously get Vaddio support with your camera.
Folks like Steph.
Yes. Not just me, obviously. I'm not the only person.
Lots of other folks like Steph.
Yes. Yeah. we also have some mounting options. Obviously, it ships with the thin profile wall mount, but there are a couple different ways that you could mount the camera if you'd like.
More than a couple.
Yes, more than a couple. We have a half-recessed in-wall box. There's a flush mount so that you can mount it to flushly to a drop tile ceiling. We have a drop down pole mount if you want to get a little bit more distance between the ceiling and where your camera's going to live. And then we do also have a half recessed in ceiling mount. Now I do want to note for the half recessed that there's like an IR trim ring because the front of the camera where you would normally point a remote is buried in the ceiling. And we have some systems that do power that IR trim ring, and the NDI is not one of them. So if you do want to still have IR control, remote control of your camera, you just add a power injector to that.
Right, when you're using that specific mount. You'll probably be using NDI control anyway. But just in case.
Just in case there's a power extension module.
That one person wants to do that.
Yep.
We got you covered. So I like to wrap up the presentation just with, okay, there's a lot of NDI cameras out on the market, and why would you pick the Vaddio camera? And I would say just because Vaddio has its roots in Pro AV. We are Pro AV folks, and our customers are Pro AV integrators and dealers, and we develop this camera based on your needs and wants. And so also that this camera is designed, manufactured, assembled here in Minnetonka, Minnesota. So we are the only PTZ camera that is kind of American-made, so Buy America TAA compliant, if that's something that you need to meet those requirements. Vaddio is an excellent solution for that. We also have the fantastic Vaddio warranty and advanced replacement options. So just talk to your sales rep for details on that. And then I guess pretty much that you've got lots of great support folks, and we are so excited that we have, as of this recording, we are the first PTZ camera that is offering that full NDI. It's not the NDIHX, and so we're super excited about, you know, it is high bandwidth, but an amazing picture quality, and excited to bring it to market. So hope to hear from you soon, and enjoy the camera. Yes. Thanks.
Thank you.